Saturday. Structural design 1, structural design 2, as well as structural design 3. Structural design 1 is already finished, in that you have studied design of steel structures. I hope you remember, in that you are design tension member, you are design compression member, you are design beam, you are design column, you are design industrial roof, you are gantry girder, roof, all the members you are design, and you are aware that how to design by using limit state method. But we know that the scope of steel structure is limited to industrial building, factory building. Whereas all the buildings which you are going to see nearby to us or in our city, most of the buildings are RCC, that is reinforced cement concrete, which is a composite structure made up of steel and concrete that we are going to study. Still, the design is not finished over here. In the next semester, we also have one more subject of the design, that is Structural Design and Drawing 3, that is SDD3. In that Structural Design and Drawing 3, we can say that we are going to study advanced design. In that advanced design of concrete element, we are going to see how to design PSC, that is nothing but the pre-stressed concrete member. Then we will see how to design earthquake, retaining wall, combined footing, water tank, that also we are going to discuss. Now, in this module, we are going to focus only on practical, that what are the different types of sheets are there that we are going to draw, that we are going to see. Only that is what the intention of this module. Now, before we see how to design and what to design and what are the sheets are there, we are going to see what is mean by structure, to which we should call structure. So, as this structural design is nothing but the basis, or we can say that the basic of structural design is nothing but structural analysis, which you already studied in structural analysis 1 and analysis 2. If you are good in analysis, then only you can design. But if you are unable to analyze, then it is very difficult to design. So in analysis also, we have seen what is mean by structure. Let me remind you what is mean by structure. We already studied that the combination of various members which are supposed to take a load is called a structure. Let me give you an example. In our this room also, we can classify some structure, some members as a structural member and some members as a non-structural member. If I ask you, dear friend, is it a structural member or non-structural member? Obviously the answer is non-structural member, because dual frame is used for privacy. It does not take any load. Similarly, we can say wall. It is not taking any load, it is non-structural member. But if I ask you the horizontal member, which we call beam and vertical member, we cannot put any size. We have to decide the size depending upon the load coming on that. So member which I need to design depending upon the load coming on that, that member is called as structural member. So when we design the various member, then to take a load throughout the life of the structure, that is called as the structural member. So you can see the combination of various members such as beam, column, footing, which are designed to take a load safely throughout the life, is called as the structural member. Now again, the question should come in the mind, what is the difference between the design and analysis? So as you have already studied analysis as well as design, you are in the mode that you can give the answer to this. Let me remind you what we have seen, what is mean by design and what is mean by analysis. So when we design, what we do, depending upon the load coming on the member, we decide the size. For example, if I take beam, we decide what should be the depth of beam.
what should be the width of beam, and the load is known to us. When load is known to us and we decide any cross section, then we call it design. In this case, we are not only going to decide the cross section, but we also decide the reinforcement in the member. So now, when we decide the dimension of the member and the reinforcement in the member, we call it design. Okay. Now, what is mean by analysis? Then, just now I have explained you design. Design is nothing but from given load, we are going to find the dimension and the reinforcement. Now, let's see what is analysis. So that is also we have studied. You have studied analysis from mechanics, strength of structural analysis 1, analysis 2. What we have done in analysis, we have calculated the stresses, we have calculated the force, we have calculated the bending moment, torsion. All this calculation of this parameter, that is shear force, bending moment, torsion, axial force, all these are called as analysis. Let me ask you one question. Suppose you are unable to find bending moment or you are unable to find shear force. We know that shear force is maximum by support. And when we do the provision of the stirrup, that should be closely spaced at the support. That must be known to you because the shear force is maximum at the support. We know generally bending moment is maximum at mid-span, and therefore the main reinforcement in the beam should be provided at the bottom to resist bending moment in case of simply supported beam. In addition to that, there will be torsion and axial force, but we must know the location and the magnitude, and then only you can do the arrangement in the member to resist these actions. So that's why analysis is very, very important. If you know analysis, design is straightforward procedure. And that's why most of the softwares are there. You might have seen that those are used for design of structural member. So that can be done by using software. But what is the use or what is the role of the structural engineer or civil engineer, we can say? Civil engineer should have a judgment. And then only we can say that, we can say whatever the input given is correct or not. For example, suppose I say that the size of the room is 5 meter. For 5 meter, if we put wrong input and if we get the depth of beam say 1 meter or 2 meter, whether it is correct or wrong, of course it will be wrong because the civil engineer having only the judgment or the thumb rule, for 1 meter, maximum depth of beam is what? 100 mm. So for 5 meter, what should be the depth of beam? 500 mm. So this is a judgment which have civil engineer, and that's why civil engineer is supposed to use the software, not the art and commerce people. They may know how to use the software, but they may not predict, they cannot judge the result. And that's why this must be known to civil engineer. Let's come to the design part. When we do any design, when we do any work, we have some objective. For design also, we have the objective. And the first and foremost objective, your design must be safe. Any design is done by designer must be safe. What it means? If I want to make my design safe, can I provide any depth? Of course it will be safe, but if I provide any depth, what will happen? It will not be economical. And that's why the first objective is safety and second objective is economy. Both should be hand in hand. But is it okay if my design is safe and economical, but within a 6 month you may find the cracks? Is it okay? No. It should be durable. And that's why the third objective is that design should be safe, economical, as well as durable. This is what our objective. We are going to study in limit state method how to make this structure safely, economical, and how it is safe or it is durable. Now, before we proceed in the curriculum, what is to be designed and what is to be done, let's see what is the sequence of the construction and what is the sequence of the design. I think all of you know the sequence of the construction. We never start the construction from slab and beam. No. We have to start from bottom, foundation, and then we can go. But when we do any design, we can't do like that. So when we design a construction or when we do the construction, it is from, first of all, footing, column, beams, which are called as siding, floor beams, and slab. This is what the construction we know. But if we want to design, or if you are going to design in the same sequence, if we design first of all footing, can we do it? Of course it is not, because when we design a footing, we must know what is the size of column, what is the size of beam, what is the size of the slab and all that. And that's why when we design, we start to design from the top. So first of all, we are going to design what? Of course, slab. And the load of the slab is transferred to beam. Then after slab, we are going to design beam. Then we can design column, and ultimately we can design footing, as well as if there is a staircase and that we can design. We should keep in the mind that the sequence of the construction is from bottom to top, whereas for design it is from top to bottom. Okay. Now let's come to the curriculum part. What syllabus says that what we are to actually supposed to do? If you see the syllabus, it is given in the syllabus that in structural design 2, you have to design G plus 2 story, and that G plus 2 story may be residential, it may be commercial, it may be public, and one care should be taken. All types of slab, you will see what are the different types of slab depending upon their end condition. All types of beam may be simply supported, continuous, cantilever, overhanging. All types of beam, all types of column, axial, uniaxial, biaxial, all types of footing as well as staircase should be covered. So when we are going to select a plan, we have to select a plan of G plus 2 building, and all these we are going to design. The second point, when we are going to select a plan, should be kept in the mind, because it may be possible that somebody will bring the plan of having very small area, somebody will bring the plan of having a large area. So we should not do like that. The clear cut guidelines are given in the curriculum that the plan area should not be less than 150 square meter. Can we make a judgment? If I ask you, what is the plan area of single room, general room? Is it or not? So we have general room, say 3.5 by 3, or we can say 10 square meter. So how many rooms are there when you are going to select? At least 5 to 6 room, and then corridor or all that. So we can simply judge whether the plan brought by the student or plan brought is sufficient or not. Actual calculation can be done, but you have to see that the plan area. Now again, G plus 2, question may be coming in the mind, whether all the floor having addition of plan area is 150. No, clear cut it is given in the syllabus that plan area of what? Each and every floor should be equal to 150 meters square minimum. If it is more than that, it is okay. Then design of all plinth beam and all ground beam. You know that the ground beam is provided on the outer periphery, and plinth beam, that beams which are provided at the plinth level. So as the restricted time is there, I am not going to see in detail. Just I'll tell you that which are the drawings are there, which are the sheets need to draw. Then we have to design all slab beams of the first floor. Clearly mention all the slab beams. Here we can make a grouping and we can design all the slab beams. Then in addition to that, there are design of columns, and the columns are axially loaded columns where the load is uniform from all the four sides. Columns, then footing from top to bottom, that is from terrace level to footing level. Then any one element by using spreadsheet, that is called as Excel. We can make a program for singly reinforced beam, we can make a program for double reinforced beam, slab, column, but one element should be designed by using the spreadsheet, that is Excel sheet. You can make a program, input will be grade of concrete, grade of steel, and the length, and the complete design should be obtained in the Excel sheet. That is what the intention of this. So this is what A part. A part completes or comprises this. When we see in A part, it is clearly mentioned that the detailing should be as per IS 13920 or SP34. And then you are supposed to draw four full empirical sheets, out of which one structural plan drawing sheet shall be using drafting sharpener. It is clearly mentioned, earlier it was said one sheet, but now here it is clearly said that the first sheet, which is the sheet of drafting software, should be drawn by using first sheet should be drawn by using drafting software of structural plan. Rest of the sheet must be drawn manually, hand drawing. Then second part, there are two site visits which are for building under construction. One may be for substructure and another for superstructure, for footing and for slab. The first visit may be for slab, beam, column, and second site visit should be for footing. It is clearly said that when you prepare a group of the student, the number of group or the number of student in a group should not be more than 4. So we should be very careful when we are preparing a group. The number of student in a group should not be more than 4. Now here I want to remind that this subject only consists of 50 marks for oral as well as 50 marks for theory, and 50 marks for oral, 50 marks for term work, and 100 marks for theory. The weightage for SD2 is 200 marks, because it is very very important subject, because almost all the design is of RC2. What we are going to do in SD3, we are going to study advanced structure. So if you want to go in special domain, then only we design SD3. SD1, that is steel structure. So if you want to go in factory building, that is steel structure. But most commonly you come across with this subject or with this, that is RCC, and that's why the maximum weightage is given. So as it is said in the syllabus, we are going to design G plus 2 building. So here I have given the cross section. You can observe plinth level, first floor, second floor, and roof. So many times it is difficult to imagine to the student G plus 2 means what. So this is the ground floor, first floor, G plus 1, G plus 2, and this is what? Roof. So we can say that if we see the sectional element, ground floor, first floor, second floor, and roof. If I ask you, in G plus 2 building, how many slabs are there? We can very easily count. 1, 2, and 3. 3 slabs are need to design. Now, here itself, I want to ask you some questions, and then we will see some more requirements how to select the plan. When we are going to design a slab, let's take a multi-story building. Here it is G plus 2, but when we go for multi-story building, as we go towards the top, say you are designing a slab of first floor, and we are going to design a slab of 10th floor. Is the thickness is same, or the thickness of slab of 10th floor is lesser than the thickness of slab of first floor?
Same.
Of course the thickness is same. The reason is that what load for which we are going to design a slab? Dead load and live load. Dead load is same and live load is also on each floor the same, except the terrace. Terrace we consider slightly less. But all other intermediate floor, the load is same, means the thickness of slab in multi-story building is almost same. Is it same for beam? What happened? Beam is supposed to take a load of slab. Beam is supposed to take a load of slab. So as the load of slab is same, is the load of or the beam is also same, or it is different? What is your opinion? If I say 30-story building, the beam of 30th story and the first story, will it be same?
If you are considering vertical loads, then it will be same.
If we consider, in this subject, we are going to consider only gravity load. Let me clear what is meant by gravity load, dead load and live. We don't bother about lateral load. And that's why if you consider gravity load only, there will not be any change, because the load which you are going to consider is same. And that's why we can say that the size of the beam at every floor is same. Is it the same case in case of column? Of course not. When we design a column, the size of column and the reinforcement in upper story is less than that of lower story. If you see the column of lowermost story, basement, what will happen? Maximum size and the reinforcement is also more, is it or not, than the upper story. So that you should keep in the mind. Now, before I proceed, let's see, because when you are going to design any G plus 2 building, you have to select first of all plan. And when you select the plan, your idea should be clear that how to select the plan. There is not only one criteria, plan area should be more than 150 square meter. Some other criteria are also there which we have seen. Once again, we'll revise. See, the first thing is clearly said that the plan area of each floor should be 150 square meter minimum. Then many times it may happen that the students are very smart and they select the 150 square meter but exactly symmetric. Same on this side and same on this side, 75 and 75, is it okay? Not at all. If it is symmetric, then it should be minimum 300. Unsymmetric, if it is symmetric, then it should be double. Though it should not be symmetric, then it may be possible that the students are having very interesting and they may bring a plan of different complex shape, but they are the beginners. We should suggest them that you are the beginners, you are not supposed to select a complex plan. Once you are become aware of that and familiar with the design, then you can design a complex plan also. But let's start with the simple plan. So don't allow them to select a complex plan. Then almost you have to take care and you have to see whether the all types of slabs are covered. Maybe slab simply supported. Two-way also different end conditions are there. Cantilever is there. Continuous is there. So it's the job of teacher to see whether all the types of slab is covered. All the types of beam is covered. There should be a simply supported beam. There should be a continuous beam. There should be overhanging beam. All types of beam should be covered. Then all types of footing and column should be covered. So if it is not covered, then we cannot give the permission blindly that yes, okay, 150 square meter, you see, select this plan. So this is very initial step, and we should allow the plan in such a way that all types of this structural member should cover in that. And of course, as clearly syllabus says, it should have staircase, because G+2, the vertical circulation is there, and for vertical circulation staircase is must. And in staircase you have two options, either dogleg or open well staircase. So you can ask them to bring the plan, maybe any of the shape. This is dogleg staircase. You can show them open well staircase. Now I am not going to go in the detailed design because time doesn't permit. So just I'll here explain you that which are the five sheets. See, actually the syllabus says that only four empirical sheets. But when we actually draw the sheets, four empirical sheets are not sufficient. And that's why I suggest instead of four, draw five sheets. So I have prepared a layout of five sheets, and in that I have said that what should be drawn where. And that I think sufficient at this level. So when we draw the first sheet is of structural plan. This structural plan should consist typical floor plan, that is a ground floor, typical floor plan of first floor and second floor, then the beam layout at plinth level, floor and the slab level, then elevation section along x, section along y, foundation plan, construction notes and schedule of slab. So if you know that what to draw, I think you can very easily draw that sheet. So this is the layout which shows that what is expected in the first sheet. Then after first sheet, that is of structural plan, the of course schedule of construction notes and then schedule of slab, there should be a typical section there for the sub slab, that is what expected. Then second sheet, once you draw a structural plan, that is a key plan, then as I said, we are going to start the design from the top. So we have to design slab. And when we are going to design slab, reinforcement detail, we must show, this is the main first of all, that is the reinforcement details of one-way, two-way slab with torsion steel. The complete plan is there, which may be show where is the reinforcement, where is the torsion steel, which is one-way, which is cantilever, then everything can be shown. And then typical cross-section reinforcement detail at top and bottom. Here we can prepare a schedule that where is the bar, what is the diameter of bar, what is the spacing. We can view S1, S2 and S3, and then we can draw section along X and section along Y. So let me remind you, the first sheet of structural plan, after drawing structural plan, you have to design a slab, and then second sheet of slab. Then the third sheet is of staircase, whatever it may be a dogleg staircase or open well staircase. The third sheet is of staircase, where you can show the reinforcement, you can show staircase. This we are going to show staircase analysis BMD. Let me explain this. Actually, when we show any details, we don't send any analysis. But this sheet is drawn for academic purpose, and that's why I have introduced here BMD. But when we see any sheet on the field, it is not expected to draw any SMP or BMD. So that we have to keep in the mind, and student must know this and all other details of flight 1 and flight 2. So structural plan, slab, and then third sheet is of staircase. After that, design of beam, which is very very important. And in design of beam, the beam should be at plinth level, beam at slab level, schedule, construction note. And the last sheet is of course, footing and column.
So this is what the last sheet where we are going to show footing and column. This completely last sheet. The first is of structural plan, second is of slabs, third is of staircase, fourth is of beam, and fifth is of column and footing. That is what the flow sequence, the same sequence in which you are going to design, in the same sequence you are going to draw. This completes your first part of the term work, that is design of V plus 2 story. I hope you remember the second part of the term work. What is that? Site visit. The second part of the term work, site visit, as I said, substructure and superstructure. So as you are going to design first of all slab beam and staircase, so you have to give the visit to the site which is under construction to see the reinforcement of slab, footing and staircase, and then you can do for substructure, footing and column. So this is what the complete of the term work. Because of shortage of time, I cannot go in detail. This is just an outline that what we are going to do in the term work.